الله أكبر الله أكبر.
الحمد لله والعباد تبز والذنب ويغني ويذكر كل يوم وفي شعر أحمده على صفاته جملة الإحسان وأشكره على نعمه الجزاء وبالشكر يزيد العطاء ويشكره سبحانه أن هدانا للتقوى ويسر لنا سبلنا وأكرمنا بجمال التقوى العديدة ومنافعها العظيمة وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث إلى الإنس والجان وعلى أصحابه والتابعين بإحسان. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فلا نجاة للمسلمين من النار ولا دخول لكم إلى الجنة إلا بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى. وقد أعصر الله تعالى بالتقوى في كتابه الكريم في أكثر من آية كريمة، ومن ذلك قوله سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أيها الإخوة، اعلموا أن التقوى وصية من الله سبحانه وتعالى لجميع عباده الأولين منهم والآخرين، لقوله: ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله. وهي دعوة جميع الأنبياء، ومن خلالها نفرق بين الحق والباطل وبين الهدى والضلالة، وهي النور الذي تنشط بالسرور، وهي عنوان لكرامة العبد في الدنيا والآخرة، لقوله تعالى: إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير. وقد قال المفسرون في بيانهم لقوله تعالى: إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم، أن التقوى هو أشرف الناس وأكرمهم، وذلك لأن التقوى سبب في كمال النفس وأساس التفضيل بين البشر. أيها المسلمون، إن التقوى سبب من أسباب الدخول إلى الجنة ومحو السيئات وتهينة الله تعالى لأسباب الفلاح، كما أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يرفع عباده المتقين فوق الناس يوم القيامة لقوله: والذين اتقوا فوقهم يوم القيامة. بالإضافة إلى ذلك، فإن الرحمة تتنزل على المسلم بسبب تقواه ويبشر سعادها في الدنيا والآخرة. أيها الفقراء، يستطيع المسلم الوصول إلى التقوى من خلال تصحيح عقيدته وسلوكه، بحيث تكون وفق ما يريد الله تعالى، وذلك من خلال فعل كل ما يرضيه واجتناب كل ما يرضيه. ويعد الإيمان بسبب من أسباب الوصول إلى التقوى لقوله تعالى: ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض. وأتمنى بيت الله سبحانه وتعالى you see his salt and you see his forgiveness. We also believe and testify that in the one greater of worship, no one is greater of worship except him, who sends salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions, and those who follow the right course by the will of Allah. Respected brothers, brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, the topic for today's khutbah is going to be about the importance and benefits of having taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the first place, what is taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Many people translate taqwa as the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Others regard taqwa as the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other regards taqwa as the fight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I'd like us to remind brothers and sisters of when Abu Hurairah
الله عنه was asked what takwa is, he gave an example. He asked the person, if you are going to walk in a Tony path, how are you going to do that? And the companion replied that, I will hold on to my clothes and walk gently and pass the way, and walk in the way without anything happening to my clothes. Then Abu Bakr said, yeah, that is the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, in his explanation of the book Fath al-Bari, said, تقوى أن تجعل بينك وبين الله عذاب الله بقايا بانتصار أوامره واجتناب نواهيه. That there should be a barrier between you and your sins that you commit against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means there should be a protection between you and yourself and the sins that you commit against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by obeying His commandments and also preventing yourself from things that are going to be disobedience against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Abd al-Rahman al-Akhdar in his kitab, he said, ويجب عليه أن يحافظ على حدود الله ويقف عند أمره ونهيه. That as a mukallif, as a looter, as a man, you suppose to protect and guide in the commandments and the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقف عند أمره, by following what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to do, ونهيه, and whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. And verily we have recommended to the people of the scripture before you and you to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is important as a Muslim to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consciousness and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, because the wise believer is the one who knows that and understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of whatever actions he does in. Indeed, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Hadid, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you, so wherever you are, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the overseer of what you do. So respect others and brothers and sisters in Islam, we need as Muslims to protect ourselves from the harm or the sins in which we commit against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Ibn Rajab rahimahullah ta'ala said, the essence of the taqwa is to make a shawl to you guys against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anger and punishment. The shawl is to obey His commandments and abstain from His prohibitions. Subhanallah, Umar ibn Aziz rahimahullah ta'ala in his speech said, that there is a provision for every day, so that so you should take the best provision, which is taqwa, from this life to the hereafter. That you should be just like those who have witnessed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comments, and so that you feel fear of His comments and eagerness to ask for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respect all the elders and brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conscious. Whatever thing that you are going to do as a Muslim, you ask yourself what is stipulated in the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَعُوْلُوَّهَا كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُمُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاهُ. That you should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you see him. For even though you cannot see him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respect our brothers and brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us about the day when we are going to face, when we are going to come face to face with Him, the deeds that we send forward to Him. Respect our brothers, remember the day we are going to catch up with all the evil that we send forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I say that the Surah Al-Adimah, يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا وما عملت من سوء تود لو ان بينها وبينه امدا بعيدا ويحذره الله نفسه. On the day when every person will be confronted with the wrong he has done and the evil he has done. وما عملت من سوء لإبه يتود لو ان بينها وبينه امدا بعيدا. He will wish that there were a great distance between him and his devil ويحذره الله نفسه. سبحان الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said he warns you against himself. He warns you of his punishment. It's عذاب الله شديد. The torment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to put on us if you obey his legislation. Brothers and sisters in iman, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Al-Tirmidhi has related that Abu Dharr and Mu'adh ibn Jabal رضي الله عنهما reported that the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اتقوا الله حيثما كنت واتقوا السيئة المحسنة تملكها وخالق الناس بخلق الحسن. I should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Do the good deeds after doing the bad ones. That the former will wipe out the latter. اتقوا الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you find yourself. Sirran, whether you are alone in your room, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you are out there in the public, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't be someone when you are out with people, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when secretly you are alone, you disobey the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers and brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have this consciousness. And it is only due to the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever you hear a call for adhan, hayya ala salah, hayya ala falah, you are eager to go and perform ablution and come to the masjid. Whenever you are walking in the streets on campus, you lower your gaze. It will be due to the consciousness that you are having of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will lead you to lower your gaze. So respected elders and brothers and sisters in Islam, you must have the consciousness, the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, you cannot fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the verse of taqwa was revealed that companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the party. Then he came to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, indeed we know we need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we cannot fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to fear him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him this, taqullaha mastata'at. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. الله سبحانه وتعالى كان أسرقه بعد الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم من آخر من الآيات الحكيم. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم كل ذنبي فاستغفروه إنه من الله الغفور.
Then the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the
تقوى الله وحسن خلقه. That the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consciousness and having a good character and conduct.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that.
Indeed, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala causes the general affairs of mankind to be easy. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qara, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. That then whosoever has the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will make matter for him very easy. That is why, if you look at Surah Al-Zayn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَالتَّقَى. That as for him who gives and has the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَصَدَّقَ مِنْ يُسْرًا. And believing at Husna, the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will smooth for you the path of peace. Whenever you are facing two challenges, because of your consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the way easy for you. Taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala causes the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be able to distinguish the truth from the falsehood, and to have the knowledge of each, have the knowledge of what true is, and have the knowledge of what false is. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Anfal, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. When you are who believe, if you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will grant you al-furqan. He will allow you to be able to distinguish between what is and what is bad. Also, whoever has the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide a way out of difficulty for him and give him permission and ease from where he would never imagine. That will take us to the verse which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. That reminds me of the story of one of the predecessors, Hafim al-Assam. He wanted to go for Hajj, and he came to his family and told them that I want to embark on Hajj, but I have a little provision for you to take care of yourself before I go to Hajj. Then the wife said, why don't you wait when you are capable of providing for us to come back then you go? Then he asked a small daughter and she said that you should go. In Allah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a provider for who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of us. So this Salaf embarked on his journey to Hajj, and some few days the provision finished. They decided leaving the little daughter to have big mouth. That is good. Why do you see now there's nothing in the house? Then she was sudden and she went at the back of the house and she started asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anta qulta wa qawluka al-haq. Wa man yattaqi Allaha yaj'al lahu makhraja wa yarzuqhu min haythu la yahtasib. That indeed you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you said, and your speech is the truth. You said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. If you have the taqwa for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'll make a way out for you. وَيَرْزُقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And I'll provide provision for you that you never imagine. Then, before she even puts her hand up, someone knocked at the door. She went in and it was one of the guards of the governor. And the guard said, we need water. We are with the governor. He's this. She went in and she fetched water for them and said, then he went and gave it to the governor. And the governor drank the water and he felt delight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put delight in the water. So where is this water coming from? The water is very sweet. Then they said, the house of Hafim al-Assam, he said, then let's go and greet him. If he was happy, Then one of the guys said, he's not there, he went to Hajj. Then he said, we need to take care of his family since he's not there. It is our responsibility to take care of the family. Then he moved his wallet. During those days, they used to have a port where he should be tied in once. So he moved his and threw it into the house. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give them more. Then the governor said, anyone that loves me should also be seen. Then all the guys is interacting with their bed, they throw it into. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. If you have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide an open way for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us taqwa. Indeed, having the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala causes our deeds to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from only those that have taqwa. You don't have taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't accept you. Respect all others and merits and success in Islam. What are the steps? I have some few steps for us that can make us increase our taqwa. We need the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One, you should do everything to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The concept of ikhlas. Whatever thing that you are going to do should be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't command you to worship except with what? مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. You have sincerity in the religion. Sincerity in the religion. You are doing so for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not for the sake of any other human being except Allah. You are praying because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not because you don't want people to say you don't pray. So for Zuhur you pray, asking you to pray, but those salawat that people do not need to see you to testify that you pray, which is Fajr and Isha, those who don't pray. And whenever you see people, you are in the workplace and everyone is praying, you pray, when you are alone, you don't pray. Whatever action that you do, that you do, that you will embark on, you should do it for the sake of only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respect all brothers and brothers and sisters. The second one is recite the Quran with Islam. Get inspired by the Quran. Get motivated by the Quran. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلِي مِنْ مُنْكَرٍ. You should contemplate over the texts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because nothing can be the power of the Quran. قرأ القرآن وعمل بما فيه. Recite the Quran and you went with the Quran. فحل حلالا وحرم حراما. This is halal, you do. This is haram, you prevent yourself from that. And also the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the Quran itself is bad. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى said, والقرآن the Quran itself is remembrance. But you can also decide to keep your tongue moist with the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When two Medians came to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and one asked him, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of what? Person. Then the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, someone that have long life and also have what? Good deeds. The other one also asked the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the deeds and the instructions of the deen of Islam is too many. Give me something that I will stick to. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يزال لسانك رطبا لذكر الله. That you should keep your tongue all the time moist in the glorification and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadith of Abu Huraira, my man sent me right. He said, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان الرحمن سبحان الله وبحمده. سبحان الله العظيم. That كلمتان خفيفتان على الإنسان. There are two words that proclaiming them are very easy for the tongue. ثقيلتان في الميزان but have a very value when it is weighed on the scale. حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. In these ways Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. He said subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim. All the time when you are walking on campus you will get subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim. And also be with good company. As Muslims, if you want to attain the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your friends should be people that have that fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You shouldn't be someone that fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and mingle yourself with someone that does not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, on the day of Qiyamah, Al-Akhilla wa yawmali min ba'adhum li ba'adhum li ya'adhum li ya'adhum. On the day of judgment, friends should be enemies to each other except what? The righteous one, except the people that you should fear and have consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they will do. So let's say possible to mingle with friends that have the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these people will motivate you in doing good. And also learning the deen of Islam. Before you attain taqwa, you learn it is opportunity. You learn the deen of Islam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you taqwa. You also have taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach you the deen of Islam. Because as a Muslim, if you don't have the knowledge of the deen, shaitan is going to mess with you. Allah, you see something that is, you think is good, but shaitan is just pushing you. It's not something that is being legislated in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also stay away from mental sins and minor sins as well, which is already the meaning of what that was. And also remind ourselves in depth. And also regular visitation of the cemetery so that you be reminded of your heart, the purpose of this world and where you are going. For indeed you will not send that ever to know what you are in and you will follow the law of the Yara. For the truth they are in that you will be able to get in the other facts. Every soul shall feel death, then you will be paid your wages in full of the day of resurrection. So indeed, when you say I'm inside or what does it, someone that is being prevented from the hellfire and being put into the gardens, Papa the fast. That is what the person that is successful. For indeed the one that is successful. Not the one that have the wealth, that have everything in this world, but those that are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Mutabina Nafat. The second brothers and sisters in man. Taqwa is the greatest and best investment that we can do in this world to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleasing us. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us careful of Him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the righteous ones, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should make us people that strive in getting used to be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, there are three things that as a Muslim is need to be your divine bond. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have His conscience. وَبَتَوُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَ. And you also try in getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever thing that is going to make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is what you need to do. وَجَدِلِ الْوَسِيلَ. And you need to strive in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the divine formula for you on this world. In Allah wa ta'ala, wa sallamina ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallimu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala abdika wa rasulika nabiyyina Muhammad. Wa Allahumma an wa ta'ala wa rasulika min al-ummati. Ma'ayyina al-baqa wa qawla wa rahman wa ma'ayyina. وأنا صائم من صائم إلى تقييم وعلى التأمين والتدعم بسالم إلى ربي. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وعلى الشر والمشركين وتولى أعداء الدين. اللهم أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت. أنت الغني ونحن الفقراء إليك. أنزل علينا الغيث ولا تجعل